first note. My aunt. So, Uncle Allen and Abel.
And
they lived at the end of the road.
So when you were young, you came here to a few cemeteries, a few funerals.
Here to a lot of people who buried here.
And you said it was a little more clear.
A little more clear then. Mm-hmm. When all these trees and stuff like that. It was a clear road. You just come down here. Walking on Cunningham and Hughes. They buried most of the people down here, my family. And my grandfather, my grandmother. And I'm standing here on my grandmother's grave with Mr. Adams. This is his daughter's.
We started back in June 10th, 2014, trying to get things together so we could make this a better place. It had been abandoned so long. And we are so proud to say that it's on its way. This is a place where we can do, where they can be recognized and respected.
What do you think is the earliest graves in this cemetery, in the Flippen Cemetery?
It's the early 1800s. I am on up because we had a group of all churches connection is right down here at this church. And we just thank the Lord that we can do what we can with what's left.
Okay, so what we're doing today is we're using a sub-decimeter GPS unit to locate graves in the Flippen Cemetery. And so we have the unit where Robin is taking her readings, and we're taking a reading at each end of the grave, which we can then use to create an accurate map of the graves and the whole cemetery in a program called ArcGIS, and we'll have all that back out in about a week's time.
A lot of improvements have been made since we started this project. When we first started this project, it was in bad, bad shape. The old tires and garbage and rubbish and everything, but there's been a lot of cleanup and it's been much improved, but there's a lot more to do to get to where we envision this to be. That sort of makes me sad is that the families of all the people laid here, they can't come down here and put flowers on their grandmother's grave or their grand. They can't come and spend a moment with their relatives because of the condition of the graveyard, or they may not even know where it is now. And it's just sad for the families of these relatives just to think that their people were just thrown out here and just thrown away. So it would be nice to be able to have a place that those families could come back and pay respect to their relatives.
We thank the Lord for this opportunity to be able to get help from the angels of the Lord. The Boy Scouts, her son, Victor, he came in here with the biggest rake, and he was raking hard, and I was raking hard, and they had the grown-ups with them, and the young people just enjoyed it so much, and we are looking for it. It's very important to know where you come from so you know how you got there. You don't want to know how you got there if you don't know where you've been. So this is making history, because these, our ancestors, our people, working very hard, and all our goal is to try to give them a respectable place to rest their bones or something.
Rest in peace.
Rest in peace. Greensburg to do the best they could, when they could, long as they could. So we got to pick up the pieces from that and do the best we can do to make things better for the years to come, so they might be gone, but not forgotten.